Good morning, students. I am Rajeshwari, Assistant Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Government College of Technology, Coimbatore. I am going to handle metrology and inspection, then one more topic, computer integrated manufacturing. It is the first lecture under the topic of CIM, computer integrated manufacturing. What are the contents? Today we are going to discuss what is computer aided design, what is CAM, what is CIM, what is automation, various types of automation, what are the components in a flexible manufacturing system, at last previous year questions and answers. What is computer aided design? A computer can be used to create, modify, analysis and optimization of a design. What are the functions of computer aided design? There are four functions in a CAD system. First one, geometric modeling. Creation of an object is called modeling. Using geometric entities are used like point, line, circle, arc, etc. That's why it is called geometric modeling. The models may be 2D or 3D model. 3D modeling techniques are used. Example, wireframe, surface and solid modeling techniques. The second function of CAD is the engineering analysis. It improves the design of the created model. Here we can check the suitability of created model design. Example, stress analysis, kinematic analysis, heat transfer analysis or dynamic analysis have done here for improving the design using analyzing software. Then third function, design review and evaluation. Here we have to check the accuracy of the design. It means to simulate the created model using simulation software. Example, pollution simulation or robotic simulation, etc. The last function, automated drafting and documentation. It is the process of creating drawings in the CAD database. For each function, different softwares are used. The various softwares for used in CAD system for modeling: Creo, CATIA, SolidWorks, Autodesk or Inverter can be used. For analysis and optimization or simulation, ANSYS, Mastron, HyperWorks, HyperMesh, Adams, etc. There are n number of softwares available for different applications. The various CAD tools require to support the design process. For concept design, geometric modeling tools, modeling softwares can be used for manipulation, for creating the model and visualize the product in a computer. For modeling and simulation, after creating the model, the model is subjected to animation and simulation. Design analysis packages are used here. Design optimization, it is for customized applications. Example, structural optimization, etc. Design evaluation, dimensioning, tolerances, kinematic packages for link assembly, etc. Here we can evaluate the design using limits and tolerances, any errors in assembly level. We can modify the model or resize the model at any time. Last one, documentation. drafting and detailing are done in communication and documentation phase. Then CAM, computer aided manufacturing. Here a computer can be used to plan, manage and control the operations in a manufacturing plant. The manufacturing plant has n number of functions. The computer is used to planning the manufacturing operations or managing the operation or controlling the manufacturing process. This process can be divided into manufacturing planning and manufacturing control. Under the manufacturing control, we can plan the process planning, then we have to do write the NC part programming, then we have to finalize the machinability data for machining like speed, feed, depth of cut, etc. Then we have to calculate the time standard for every operation. Based on the time calculation for individual operation, individual product time for making the component, we have to finalize the unit price of the component. It is also done by a computer software. It's a cost estimation. Then production and inventory planning. What are the inventory plan is done for a particular component. Then computer aided assembly line balancing. These are all manufacturing planning activities under CAM. CAM applications in manufacturing control are process monitoring during component fabrication or during machining or during casting process, any of the manufacturing process, you have to monitor the process. Therefore, the process is controlled. Then quality control to reduce the wastage, scrap. Shop floor control, controlling the equipment's machine. Then inventory control, then just-in-time production system, computer-aided quality assurance, the last one, computer-aided inspection. These are all controlling the manufacturing activities. The tools used in CAM function, manufacturing phase, process planning, for process planning, computer-aided process planning techniques. CAPP is divided into two techniques, retrieval type, then one more variant type. Sorry, retrieval or variant type, then one more generative type. In generative type CAPP, using the artificial intelligence tool, we can develop the process planning sheet. In retrieval type or variant type, we can create the process planning sheet in previous sheet available in the computer database. Then cost analysis, material and tooling specification, these are all process planning. Cost estimation, material requirement planning, tool requirement, then manufacturing resource planning, MRP2. These are all under process planning phase. Then part programming phase has to write a NC part programming for the component. Then inspection phase has computer aided quality and inspection softwares are used. In assembly phase, robotic simulation and programming can be used. Then what is the need for using computer aided design and computer aided manufacturing? By using a computer, we can increase the productivity of designer, it improves the quality of design, it improves the communications, it creates a manufacturing database, it's a common database for both design and manufacturing. It creates test toolbox and optimize them, then it helps in production scheduling and MRP models. MRP means material requirement planning models. It has effective shop floor control. These are the advantages of using computer aided design and manufacturing. And what is concurrent engineering or simultaneous engineering, or one more name called parallel engineering? It is a technique used to improve the efficiency of product design and reduce product development cycle time. Here, a team of people interacted with each other for developing a product design. Therefore, product development cycle time is reduced. The team consists of one designer, one process planner, one quality checker, then one machine operator, then salesman. All are available in a team. They are interacted with each other for creating a product development stage. They used here the design for manufacturing assembly, design for manufacturing and assembly techniques, and failure mode effective analysis techniques here. It improves workflow and also it eliminates any conflicts and procedures for developing a manufacturing a product design and manufacturing. Then SIM, it is the integration of CAD and CAM is called SIM, Computer Integrated Manufacturing. It integrates all components involved in the production of a product or item. The engineering functions including NC, CNC, DNC, CAD-CAM, GT, it's a group technology, it's a manufacturing concept, you know, it improves the production. Here we can grouping the components based on the similarities on design or similarities in manufacturing sequence of operations. Then computer aided process planning, then material requirement planning, then one more, material handling equipments. These are all integrated: design stage, manufacturing stage, material handling equipment, planning, all are included. In addition to that, business activities also included in computer integrated manufacturing. The integration media is used here in terms of LAN, WAN, internet technology. It's a block diagram of SIM. It's a CAD. These two are CAM, manufacturing planning and control. These two activities, additionally, business functions are added or included. Business functions may be sales and marketing. Sales functions and marketing functions are included. Then sales forecasting, order entry, so order from customer requirement, cost accounting, customer billing. These are all business functions. SIM consists of design, planning, control and office functions. The four quadrants are called computer integrated manufacturing. A number of activities and operations like designing, analyzing, testing, manufacturing, packaging, then quality control, etc. are involved in the life cycle of a product or system. The various applications of automation to each of these individual activities enhancing the productivity only at the individual level. These are termed as islands of automation. Each and every stage is a separate automation. Now, what are the advantages of SIM? SIM has n number of advantages, like it is suitable for batch type of production. Due to the high flexibility and automation, monitoring of system at all times, machines are utilized in very high level, fewer errors and wastage occur, improvements in productivity and quality control, greater consistency, less unit price of product, higher quality of finish, parts easily manufactured and changed. It reduces lead time and also it reduces manpower. SIM has also some disadvantages. They are detailed manufacturing plan is required. It requires an expensive investment. The hourly price rate is high. Compared to conventional machines, require more careful handling and maintenance. Periodic maintenance is necessary. It involves difficulties in adapting working patterns of new technology. Workers' training is needed. Reduction in short-term profit. Then automation. This is technology concerning with various applications like mechanical, electrical, electronic, hydraulic, pneumatic or computer-based system in the operation and controlling a production. The various automating industries are, example, continuous process industries, cement factories, sugar factories, chemical industries. They have produced throughout the year the particular product only, sugar or cement or chemical factories. Mass production industries, they have producing automobile components or FMCG products, fast moving consumer goods, etc. Then third type of industries, batch production industries, they have different variety of products at a different schedule, machines, manufacturing or aircraft, etc. The last one, job production industries, here they have produced prototypes, heat exchanger factories or chemical factories, etc. There are three types of automation: fixed, flexible and programmable automation. Fixed automation or hall automation. Here they can producing a standardized product. Here we can invest very costlier machines or custom engineer equipments. It is used for very large quantity production, relatively inflexible in accommodating product variety. Here, throughout the year, mass production is used. Therefore, the same product can be produced throughout the year. Highly specialized tools, devices, equipments, special purpose machine tools are utilized to produce a product. Very efficient and high production rate, the unit price of the component is very less in fixed automation. Then flexible automation, it is also known as flexible manufacturing system. It uses CAD/CAM system. Here also high investment is needed. Producing different products on the same equipment in any order, any mix. Continuous production of variable mixtures of parts. At any time, we can change the part size or part style. We can change the component design. Then medium production rates, previous one large production rate, this one medium production rate, flexibility with design variations. Example, machines are used in flexible automation, CNC machines. Soft automation or programmable automation. Here we can change the design of the product or even change the product by changing the program. By using the program, we can develop a product, producing a product used for the low quantity production of large number of different components. Here the quantity of production is very less, but variety of components is very high. By changing the program, equipment are designed to be flexible or programmable. High investment in general purpose equipment, most suitable for batch production, lower production rates than fixed automation. With the chart indicates the different types of automation with respect to the product variety and production quantity. Fixed automation or hard automation is used for mass production. Here variety of parts is very less, but quantity to be produced per year more than 10,000 components to 1 lakh, more than 1 lakh components. is used under mass production. Then medium variety, medium quantity of the components to be produced under flexible automation, it is used for batch type production. Then third one, programmable or soft automation. Here we have produced more variety of components but less number of quantity in programmable automation. The line indicates below this line we can producing the component by manual process. Layout means what are the equipment facilities available in a factory, how they are arranged is called layout. The first type of layout is fixed position layout. Here the workers and processing equipment are brought to the product rather than moving the product to the product to the equipment. Example, shipbuilding industries. Here we can move the worker equipments used for shipbuilding, all are going to the product. Second one, process type of layout or process layout or functional layout. Here the equipments are arranged according to the function or type. Example, this is a lathe section for producing cylindrical component, this one milling section for producing rectangular type, this one grinding for finishing operation. The equipment machineries are arranged according to the processes or functional. That's why it is called process or functional layout. Here the parts can be moved each and every section. Here material handling is more. Previous one, there is no material handling. The product is fixed. Worker and equipments are brought to the product. Then third one, cellular layer. It is available in group technology principle. Each cell is designed to produce a limited variety of part configuration. The cell is used for a particular part family. Part family is a collection of parts which are having either similar design or similar manufacturing attributes. They are grouped in a particular group. Grouped components are produced in a particular cell. It is called cellular manufacturing. The cellular manufacturing has a cellular layer. There are different machines are used here. There are five machines are used. Five different machines are used. The five machines are producing a group of components. They are having similar design or similar sequence of operations. This is a concept used in group technology. The last layout is the product layout. Here the sequence of machineries are arranged according to the sequence of operations needed for a particular component. Here we have five machines. They are arranged in a sequential order. The initially workflow starts from the loading station. The raw material is entered here. At the end of the line layout or product layout, the finished product it comes from another end. If the raw material is loaded here at the end, at the end of the line, we get the finished product. The five machines are used for the sequential operations required for a particular product. Here there is no backflow. The different types of layouts and the different variety and production quantity indicates this graph. Mass production using the product layout, the corresponding product has a n number of sequence of operations. Therefore, the arrangement of machines are arranged as per the need. Therefore, product layout used in mass production. Here, batch production or cellular manufacturing using the process layout. cellular layout in addition to the job shop layout also can be used here. Here medium variety, medium quantity of production in batch production. Then position layout, job shop position layout or fixed position layout. Here variety of product is high, but unit to be produced per year is very less. Less than 100 components is produced per year. Here less production, but variety is very high. Different automation and different layouts and different production are indicating this graph. This is a fixed or hard automation. Here we have using the product layout and also cellular layout, process layout. Here also the rate of production is very high. In flexible, it's a flexibility, therefore it is used in batch production. Programmable automation, here use fixed position layout. Product variety is high, less quantity to be produced per year. Here there are various automated manufacturing systems used in an industry. First one, automated machine tools or machines for preparing the manufacturing the component. Transfer lines, it performs a series of machining operations. Automated assembly systems, industrial robots, automatic material handling and storage system, automatic inspection systems for quality checking. These are the automated systems used in an industry. Next, FMS, flexible manufacturing system. It consists of one or more processing stations called workstations, interconnected by an automated material handling and storage system, which are all controlled by a distributed computer system. A FMS has a group of processing workstations. They are mechanically connected by material handling and storage system. These two are workstation and handling and storage system. These two are controlled by a electronically controlled by a computer system. What is flexibility? What are the flexibilities used in FMS? Machine flexibility means it covers system's ability to be changed to produce new product type. At any time, we can change the part to design or part to stay. It is called machine flexibility. Routing flexibility means we can change the schedule or operating instruction at any time. It is called routing flexibility. Then, major components of flexible manufacturing system. FMS consists of group of processing workstation and also tools, pictures and related hardware, then material handling and storage system, then computer control, coordinating and controlling the components. In addition to these three, human workers can also use tool positioning, supervising, loading, unloading the component, etc. Material handling system used in FMS for loading, positioning and unloading. Loading involves moving the work units into the production machine or processing equipment from a source inside the station. Positioning providing the part to be in a known location and orientation related to the workhead or tooling that performs the operation. Unloading, it removes the work from the production machine and either placed in a container at the workstation or prepared for transporting to the next workstation in a sequential process. Different handling system used in FMS. FMS has four layers: inline layer, loop layer, open page layer, then robo center layer. Inline layer is the inline transfer system, conveyor handling equipment, RGV, overhead RGV system with robotic part handling are used in inline layout. For loop layout, ferries, conveyor system, inflow tow line cars, industrial trucks can be used in loop layout. In open field layout, automated guided vehicle AGV and also inflow tow line cars are used. Robo center layout uses the industrial robo for handling the product or parts. Then we are going to discuss some of the example problems asked in previous GATE exam and also IAS exams. First one, which item best describes a ham technology? There are four options given. The question, which item best describes a ham technology? Geometric modeling, documentation, drafting, numerical control. Modeling, documentation, drafting. These three are activities or functions of FAD. Numerical control, NC, is the HAM technology. The answer D is the numerical control is the answer for this question. And example problem 2. In CAM, part programming refers to, there are four options given: generation of cutter location data, online inspection, machine selection, tool selection. Part programming indicates the generation of cutter location data. Part programming for a particular component, we have used G code and M code for developing the part program for a component. It indicates the cutter movement data. Online inspection is a wrong one. Machine selection is not the correct answer. Tool selection is also not correct. The answer is B. Part programming refers to generation of cutter location data. Then third example problem. Hard automation is also called as fixed position automation. Soft automation is called as programmable automation. Then, example problem 4. Programmable automation is suitable for different automation is used for low, medium and high production. Programmable or soft automation is suitable for, answer is A, low production volume and large variety of parts. Low production volume and large variety of parts. Here we are using the program, we can manufacturing a component. Here variety of components is high, but production rate less than 100 units produced per year. Then problem example problem 5. It's CNC, we are not discussing this lecture. A CNC machine, post processor, machining center, tool magazine, DNC, direct numerical control, FMS. Which of the following paths are correctly matched? There are three items are given. We have to find out the correct one. CNC machine is a correct one. Post processor, machining center, that is a tool magazine for storing the tool. Direct numerical control is a machine used in flexible manufacturing system. All three are correctly matched. Therefore, the answer A is correct, 1, 2 and 3. Then example problem 6. Flexible manufacturing allows for tool design and production, automated design, quick and inexpensive product chain, quality control. FMS is used for flexible manufacturing system. At any time, we can change the product type or style or design. Therefore, the answer C is the correct answer. Quick and inexpensive product change. And example problem 7. consider the following characteristics: single machine cell, manual materials handling system, computer control, random sequencing of parts to machines. Which of the above characteristics are associated with flexible manufacturing system? 1 and 2 and 3, 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 2, 3 and 4. Which of the above characteristics associated with FMS? FMS has a group of processing workstation, or single machine cell also can be used in FMS. Manual handling system also used. Computer control is also used. Sequencing of parts, random sequencing, handling equipment can be used for random sequencing. The correct answer is 1, 2 and 3. Single cell can also use a FMS, handling system, computer control. These are components of FMS. That is, the answer is A, 1, 2 and 3. These three components are used in FMS. Random sequencing of parts through machines are not used in FMS. Then example problem A, which one of the following systems is consisting of processing station, manual material handling and storage, computer control and human labor? Previously we have discussed what is FMS. These are the components of FMS. Therefore the answer is C, flexible manufacturing system. Then example problem 9, rank order clustering as applied to manufacturing automation. This is one of the techniques used in group technology for grouping the components to identify the similar design or identifying the similar manufacturing activities for grouping the components. Rank order clustering is one of the techniques used to grouping the component in a GT. A technique of identifying process sequence in production of a component, a just-in-time and approach of grouping the machines into cells in an FMS system, a tool to generate bill of materials. The correct answer is the grouping of machines into cells in an FMS system. Answer is C. It is one of the techniques to group the components. And also grouping the machines into cell in cellular manufacturing. Then example problem 10. Consider the following benefits of cell. Cell has number of benefits, number of advantages we have discussed. Less direct labor, less scrap and rework, higher machine utilization. Which of the above are correct? All these three are correct. Therefore, the answer is 1, 2 and 3. The last one, a statement, there are two statements are given. Automated guided vehicle, AGV, is a programmable mobile vehicle without human intervention and used for handling, material handling. It's a correct statement. AGV is a programmable, it's a driverless vehicle, battery operated vehicle. It is done by computer control, programmable vehicle. It is used for material handling, it's a correct term. Automated storage and retrieval system, AAS and RS, is a part of CNC machine and used for machining operation. It's one of the storage and retrieval system used in material handling. It is not a part of the CNC machine, and also it is not used for machining operation. Therefore, the answer is C. Statement 1 is true, but statement 2 is false. AS and RS is not used for machining operation. It is a storage and automated storage and retrieval system used in FMS. What is a summary? What are the topics discussed in this lecture? What is CAD, CAM and their functions? then SIM and its advantages, disadvantages of SIM, automation, different types of automation, what is flexible manufacturing system, components of flexible manufacturing system. Finally, we discussed previous example questions and answers. These are the references used in this lecture. Thank you, students, for patient listening.